You know, the work which we did yesterday was stimulating to me and kept evolving to wonderful things, wonderful feelings, because each of our stars, our superstars, arrived with a smile. That was the best part. And wanting to participate and contribute. And so that made my job much, much easier. So that was a good day for me. I come from a world of being a photojournalist years ago. I worked with Life magazine, Look magazine, and Perry Match and Stern occasionally. And so I've had a lot of experience on adapting myself. And the principle for me is you always get it. And you get it well. So, you know, I am not the kind of an individual who comes away from a day of shooting like this and say, well, it would have been good, but I really hold myself responsible and I want to make it good. And certainly the light was slipping sometimes, but then you use your experience to adapt to that. And you know, in some cases, like we have the couple sitting in at a picnic, and the light really had gone. So what we did in this case is we took an electronic flash or strobe light and shot it like the last beam of sunlight coming through, and then the sky was quite radiant, the clouds were big, and that's where exciting pictures come from. You have to keep exploring and making the most out of every chance and every opportunity you have, and that's part of your exploration and the delight of working in as a photographer in a city like Salzburg. Well, I must say one aspect of working on a project like this is you have to move. If the light is going down, you have to get it now. And you sometimes have to say to everyone, the people helping, your stars, and then the individuals in front of the camera, we've got 5 minutes, or we've got 3 minutes. And in this case, always there was 100% cooperation, and they made it work. So, yes, that can be tricky. But there was never anything lost here, because everybody did move, and the most wonderful thing was the relationship. The moment I met both of our individuals yesterday, I knew we were going to have good photographs, because there was a warmth, enthusiasm, and an instant connection, as far as I was concerned, with them. And that's what has come to this wonderful calendar. Working in front of a camera like we have done with the ZEISS calendar here is no different than being on stage for performers, great artists, great opera singers, and people in opera, because they are in the public eye and they present themselves. And you know, these individuals have done an extraordinary job of projecting to the camera, this camera that I worked with. I've been doing this, doing photography like this for more than 50 years, and for different publications, etc., and for different purposes. ZEISS has been in my life from the beginning of my career till today. And frankly, these are some of the lenses, and this is the camera I used a great deal at the beginning of my career. And this lens, for example, and this also, was the one that I photographed Marilyn Monroe with. But there was also Marlene Dietrich, Romy Schneider, and so many others, Charlie Chaplin, because these were the lenses that worked for me. And the interesting thing is, they were good years back. I see that when I go back and scan pictures from 30, 40 years ago, but they're also even better today. I don't know how they could be improved, but the best lenses for medium format are undeniably ZEISS. I only see it when I put them in my computer and blow them up, or if we blow them 6 meters wide and they stay sharp, sharp, sharp. It's a different time of technology, because when I began, we used to use large negatives to get really sharp pictures. You don't need to do that anymore. With today's technology, such as digital and ZEISS, you can make a picture go almost forever. So sometimes people say to me, do you think that digital will ever be as good as film? That's absolutely not the situation, because today's technology is far superior, and ZEISS is part of that. Sometimes I'm asked, do I ever fall in love with a specific lens and keep using it over and over? And honestly, they're all my favorites. It's like my favorite family. It was the case many years ago when I was photographing the individuals then, and it still is the case, but there's no one that's better than the other. It's like all my children. And the point is, the lenses of today from ZEISS are all totally reliable, and there's no favorite. I mean, I may have a favorite focal length for a certain purpose, but I don't find one lens to be better than the other, because, you know, the reality is no lens is of superior quality to another, because they're all at the very top as far as I can determine and see and feel in my work. This is the lens that started my career of photographing celebrities. I was photographing Elizabeth Taylor, and she was the one that gave me a break and put me from shooting fashion, which I'd been doing, to shooting celebrities almost overnight. She had not been photographed for about a year. She had been ill, and I was sent to photograph her. At first, she said she wouldn't do any more photos. She did not want to do them, and then she agreed, and the pictures went all over the world, and that put me on the map. And within months, I was working with Judy Garland. I traveled with Judy Garland for a month. I went to Toronto, where I come from originally, to Washington, D.C. in the States, and then to Hollywood, where she was working with Frank Sinatra and Dean Martin on a television special. And I spent a month there. And then we had a project to do in Berlin for the opening of the film Judgment at Nuremberg. And she was coming there because she had a part in that film. And that was just after the wall went up. It was a very unusual time. I had work to do in Hawaii, and that was quite interesting, because I was flying in a helicopter over the coastline with mountains and rainbows, spectacular rainbows. And these were the lenses I used. These were wide-angle lenses. Now, for portraits, I like lenses like this, or the standard lens. These are long lenses. We call them like telephoto lenses. And this is a normal lens, but we have wide angle lenses, and for work from a helicopter, you want to get in close and get the effect. And these went there with me, and they made pictures that are used frequently today, showing Hawaii and the spectacle of it, and the beauty of the water, the ocean, the sky, especially around sunset, just unimaginable. I was with Marilyn on three different occasions, and I met three different people. The first time was just to talk about what we do, and she surprised me, because it wasn't just a superstar. She was very much like a sister, like the girl next door. She was very normal, and that was quite a surprise. And then the next time I was with her, it was in our photo studio where we were ready to take pictures, and she stepped through the door, and she was radiant. It was unimaginable. And then the third time it was to show her pictures, and we went through a whole cycle of different events. But you know what happened to both Marilyn and I in our 2 or 3 hour session, closer to 3 hours? I really fell in love with her, and we connected. We really connected. She suggested we might do some very special things, but you know, we didn't. I just kept looking down into this camera, taking pictures. That was what was most important to me. And that's why these pictures really exist, because it's what went into the lens.